right now, if you look at most industries, it makes it seem so perfect. Like, oh, if you have enough ambition, you can start a company. You just have some friends. And if you want to create a product, you just have an amazing idea. And then, you know, you find some investors that want to help you with that idea. And I didn't find any of that to be that way, meaning that it was much more to it than just having a good idea, even just finding an investor, even just knowing what your product is and knowing that there's a market ready to receive it. All those kind of things are just the, you know, just scratching the surface. Because there's, to me, what I feel like is if things start going in one direction, like obviously the direction right now and the reality is like, okay, well, let's dumb everybody down. People don't even know how microwaves are made or even how irons are made, like simple stuff. We don't, we just buy the stuff, but we don't know what's going on in the inside. And honestly, they would love, you know, and we're using the word they, but they would love for it to stay that way. They would love for it to literally be that you don't touch this field of manufacturing and creating things, because once you do, you'll find that you create things way better than what is generally out here in the reality right now, all the squares, right? And this is another thing, like, because if you notice with Phi Aqua, the design is amazing, if I could say so myself. And when you take that, though, to like this mass production warehouse and you say, well, how much is it going to cost to get something like this done? They're going to be like, we can't even do that. Our equipment doesn't even move that way. And, you know, you got situations here that won't work out for us. So it's basically the reason why you see all these basic designs with your kitchen appliances and even your technology is because it's designed for mass production. And it's also designed for the cheapest cost for that production. So what we believe in is that if we can put more into the product, especially in the engineering, the materials, et cetera, then we would still be good financially, because we're also not trying to hog up the money and pay like only $1 for something that we're selling for $2,000. Who knows? So that's what I'm coming with here, is that to realize that we're producing here, at least our prototypes and many parts and the key components to our devices we're producing here, because this gives us not only opportunity to have complete control, it also allows our ideas to be able to manifest as fast as we have them. And that's a big thing, because, you know, I get ideas, sound ideas from what I've learned and all the things that I've studied all the time. But if I'm bogged down by this manufacturing process that I gotta go here and go there and they're still gonna tell me no, then it's not gonna happen. Likewise, we have some really good people around us. We have a couple engineers that just are really close from more of a tribe family level. So it really assists us in developing something. So that's what we're building here. And ultimately, we will hope to in the future to begin to help other people develop things, you know, but again, that's in the future. We're working on this now, and it's all about getting to completion, which is actually coming very, very soon. For those who want to know when Phi Aqua is going to be ready, we're talking tops 3 months from now. So this is an exciting time for me, but there's a lot of work. We worked all the way up until the point that the cameras cut on, and even we're a few minutes late, just because that's what it really takes. So it's great to have that energy then. It's great to, you know, do your body the right way, drink the right water, eat the right thing, so that you'll have the energy to push into your projection, and then, you know, move yourself away from anything that's pulling away from your energy and keeping you off of focus of sovereignty. So what we're doing also is, again, quality, again, over the quantity and the bulk production. Our devices are curved and they'll stick out, right? And then we have also this fast turnaround of getting an idea at least from concept to completion rather rapidly, you know, since we have everything in house. And then also we're looking at stuff and we're saying, okay, this is the best, better way to do this. So we're teaching ourselves in that process. And there's just a plethora of people out there already to draw knowledge from that already are masters at this craft of production, right? And they generally work somewhere. So you get one of those few of those people on your team, and you'd be surprised at how much you're able to create. But again, there's a lot that also goes with it. And that's what we're powering through. So what we're equipped for doing here, just to understand this facility, and you're only seeing a fraction of it. Like, we were even looking at our, you know, our cameras and trying to figure out how we can catch other stuff in different angles. There's a couple more rooms in this facility that I'm actually on. I'm kind of living and working in my facility, you know, to keep productivity going on around the clock. And so we have different things that are set up. And as we keep going, especially since we've started configuring some of these rooms, like the one you were just in, and or I was just in and that you were watching, and this room, we're configuring these rooms with more cameras and things. So that way we can get in on individual things and say, hey, this is exactly what we're doing. And that's actually what we're going to be doing also in the ambassador training. And I guess I'll just take a brief moment to just mention that for those that are looking to create something, invent something, or if you're coming from scratch and you just want to know the ropes to being successful in this society, push the right codes to get the response that you're looking for from the matrix, then that's what we're actually going to be teaching. And as I already talked about earlier, this is so dynamic. You can get involved with us. You can go to spirittechs.com/apply. You can fill out the application there, and then you can immediately become a specialist and start generating capital as soon as you post your links. And then even beyond that, if you feel like you need a little bit more, you need to know a little bit more, you need to know a few more techniques, and you need more hands-on, then we have aspirant training, and then we have ambassador training. And then what that does is it puts you into also a network of individuals that will be assisting you and also doing that with you. So it's basically a tribe. And so this is what we've just opened up at spirittechs.com. If you're interested in something like that, you may want to check it out. So that kind of brings us to the close of today's conversation. Again, I didn't want to exhaust any of these subjects because we could talk for hours just on water and frequencies alone, just on frequencies alone. We could talk a lot about manufacturing, prototyping, et cetera, but I'm just giving you the overview of why we're doing it this way, what we've been capable of doing. We have FDM machines here, which is just your standard extruder-based 3D printers with large volumes for some of our larger objects. We have SLA printing. That's actually the machine that you're seeing behind me. And that's definitely much more smoother, high resolution, fine, smooth surfaces. Actually create something that more looks like something you can put right into a store. But again, you know, you use different machines for different things, especially when you're going through the prototyping phase. We have a micro soldering station because a lot of the boards that you're seeing now within devices are like super small. And we're even considering picking up a pick and place machine, which is something that automatically puts the chips on the board. But right now, and just so you understand the process, we prototype the board so we can mill out the board. We can take the designs from the schematics of whoever's programming the board and put all those components on the board manually with the micro solder, and then actually put that in device and test the device, move certain things around, change certain things until we're done. And then we take that test board, and you would generally send that, something like that, to the person, the mass productions that have the machines like you saw in the video that just, you know, hammer all those components right into the board. We have the milling capabilities, and basically the mill is like a smaller router that basically is used to carve out chips. And you've seen that video and some of the things that I posted about the resonators, which is another amazing product that's coming along with the Phi Aqua device, something for you to place your water on to keep it stabilized. You can even put it under your bed. You can sit on it when you're meditating. It has a lot of uses. So we're rolling that in, but that's a part of how those things are developed is through the milling machine. We have curing, which is this other silver machine over here. You basically, it's full of UV lights at a certain nanometer, and it allows the resin, which is basically a liquid that comes out of this machine when it's putting something together, it hardens that liquid and makes it rock tighter based on whatever the material is and how it's supposed to be. And obviously we have engineers that help us and that put things together. Like, obviously I'm not just an idea guy. I do everything here myself, and also I lend the facilities to others that come in and assist in doing things. We have people that are remote that, you know, we have doing different things. And that's the big thing, is we're all learning. So we're always looking to, like, let's say if it's a guy, he's an engineer, he knows about all of this stuff. Well, he may not know about new productivity tools that he needs to actually enhance what he's doing in his country. And we'll give that to him and offer that to him. So it's a very symbiotic relationship. So that's it for us right now. We're going to go ahead and go to a question and answer this.